Welcome students, today we are going to start part 2nd from lesson number 7, Air and Atmosphere. In part 1st you have learned about the composition of air, constituents of air, that is oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. Now today we are going to start the next components of the air is the water vapor. And the water vapor in air, it is also known as a moisture. And students, this amount of the moisture present in air, it is also known as humidity. But the percentage proportion of water vapor in air, it is varies. Varies means students, it is changing from one place to another place. The more is the amount of the water vapor present in air, the higher is the humidity. So depending upon the moisture, the humidity is present. So the next topic is the uses of this water vapor. So water vapor determines earth climatic condition. The presence of water vapor in air causes the rain also. And at low temperature, water vapor condenses to form snow, then sleet, mist, frost, then dew, fog, etc. And students, this water vapor controls the rate of evaporation from the bodies of plants and animals. And it is essential for the growth of plants also and the good health of animals and the human beings. So students, these are all about the uses of water vapor. These are also the one constituent of air. The next one is the water cycle. What is mean by water cycle? The change of water from one form to another in nature, which results in continuous circulation of water from Earth's surface to the atmosphere and again from Earth's surface to the atmosphere and from the atmosphere back to the Earth's surface, that is called as a water cycle. When it is changing from one form to another form, means students, is changing from one state to another state. So in that way this water cycle is going on. In the water cycle, condensation process is taking place, evaporation is taking place. In that way the process is going on and the rainfall. So the water cycle is completing in that way. The next one is the inert gases. There are 6 in numbers of the inert gases. And which are the inert gases? Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon. These are the inert gases which are present in trace amount in the air. And these gases do not react with any other substances. That's why we are calling these are the inert gases. The next constituent of the air is the dust particles. These are solid, minute soil particles present in air. And the water vapor condenses around the dust particles to form the cloud. Dust particles also trap heat and help in its scattering. So, these are all about the constituents of the air. Now students, some different forms are there other than the rain, in which the water vapor present in air precipitates on earth. That is, first one is the fog. What is mean by fog? They are tiny droplets of water formed near the ground when water vapor in air condenses. Second one is the mist. Mist are tiny droplets of water which remain suspended in air, that is called as a mist. Dew. Dew is formed when water vapor condenses on cold objects. They are tiny droplets of water. We often see this on grass, leaves, flowers, etc. in winter morning. Then next one is the frost. Frozen dew is also called as a frost. Snow. Water vapor frozen into ice which falls on the ground as light flakes covering the surface where it falls is called snow. Then hail. They are small hard balls of ice which falls on the ground just like rain. Sleet. Rain and snow mixed together which falls on the ground is called as sleet. So students, these are the some related terms of the water vapor. Now students, our next topic is the air quality. Air is important for the survival of human beings, but it should be free from impurities, because our breathing process is going on with the help of the air. Air containing oxygen gas, which is very important for the respiration process. And that air, if it containing the impurities, that is harmful to our health also. So when air contains undesirable substances that are harmful to plants and animals, it is said to be polluted, and that harmful substances in air are called air pollutants. Air pollution is a major problem created by modern man. Some common pollutants in air are smoke, dust, soot, oxides of carbon, sulfur and nitrogen. Other pollutants are chlorofluorocarbon, methane and ammonia. These are all the pollutants which are making our air impure. Though air also gets polluted by natural processes like volcanic eruptions, crop pollination, etc., but mostly it is polluted by human activities. That is very important, students. Nowadays, human activities are increased, and due to these human activities, our air quality day by day it is decreasing. So, which are that activities? The first one, burning of fuel and fibers. Then next one is the cutting of forest, that we called as a deforestation. Next one is the use of chemicals like fertilizers, for example pesticides, insecticides, example urea. And students, use of chemical weapons in war, it is increasing the impurity of air. And the suspended particles which is present in smoke also. Now students, the next topic is the types of these pollutants in air and their harmful effect. So, types of pollutants in air and their harmful effect. Now this topic we are going to discuss about. And the first one is the suspended particles in smoke. Smoke is present in the air large quantity due to the burning of fossil fuels. It carries minute solid particles that causes serious respiratory problems like asthma and bronchitis. Smoke makes the atmosphere dense and reduces the visibility, leading to serious accidents. Particles of lead oxide present in the automobile exhaust can cause brain damage in children. Lead compounds formed due to burning of leaded petrol obstruct development of blood cells. Particles of mercury cause a disease called Minamata. It can lead to brain damage, paralysis and mental problems. Particles of dust, cement, ash and carbon particles, soot in smoke, may cause bronchitis, while asbestos fiber can cause a disease called as a silicosis. Sun grains too are suspended particles in air which act as a pollutant. They can cause allergic reactions in human beings. You have the lesson about allergy. In that way you will learn about the allergic reaction due to the pollen grains. The second types of pollutant is the oxides of carbon. Due to the incomplete combustion of fossil fuels, carbon monoxide is produced. And this carbon monoxide gas is poisonous and it is harmful to the human beings. Carbon monoxide is a highly poisonous gas which combines with the hemoglobin present in the blood to form a stable compound that is called as a carboxyhemoglobin. Thus, it prevents the blood to carry oxygen for respiration. Breathing in carbon monoxide rich air causes headache, dizziness, and might even lead to death also. Carbon dioxide is non-poisonous, but excess amount of carbon dioxide in atmosphere adds to global warming. The third one is the oxides of sulfur and nitrogen. Fossil fuels like coal, petrol, etc. contain sulfur and nitrogen as impurities. Therefore, when these fuels are burned, gases like sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, hydrogen sulfide, nitrogen dioxide are produced. These gases are present in variable amount in the air around big cities and industries. They are highly poisonous and cause serious respiratory problems. Oxides of nitrogen form a mixture of smoke and fog. It is also called as a smoke, which affects our eyes too. They also cause acid rain, which damages crops and buildings and natural resources like water bodies and patches of land. They can even destroy ozone layer in air, which protects us from ultraviolet radiations of the sun. Pollutants like chlorofluorocarbons, which mix in air, react with the ozone layer, causing its depletion. As a result, the density of air is reduced and ultraviolet rays from the sun reach directly to the earth. Their presence causes skin tanning and skin cancer. It also adds to global warming also. These are the four types of the pollutants which are present in air. So first one is the suspended particles. Second one is the oxides of carbon. Then third one is the oxides of sulfur and nitrogen. And the fourth one is the other pollutants. So students, here we completed about the types of pollutants. Now the next topic is the acid rain. Students, how this acid rain is forming? Listen carefully. Gases like sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, etc. react with water present in air to form sulfurous acid and sulfuric acid respectively. These acids fall on the earth with rain, making that rain is acidic and become a part of water cycle. Now students, what is mean by acid rain? A rain which is acidic in nature, that is called as an acid rain. Some chemical equations for the chemical reactions to form the acid rain. Sulfur dioxide react with water forming sulfurous acid. Sulfur trioxide react with water forming sulfuric acid. Sulfurous acid and oxygen react with each other forming sulfuric acid. Now students, the acid rain has many harmful effects. Which are these effects? We will see one by one. One, it damages wildlife in ecosystem where it falls. It can kill fishes and other aquatic animals and plants. This acid rain makes the soil more acidic and less fertile, and thus seriously damaging the growth of plants. It damages the buildings and historical monuments, those made of that marble and limestone, because acids can easily break down carbonates. Acid rain promotes corrosion of metallic structures such as abrasives, etc. Acid rain damages the nutrition level of leaves of the plant. So students, here we completed our part 2 from lesson number 7, air and atmosphere. Thank you.